And that was a healthy coyote, too.
Brian Hampton spent most of his life in an executive boardroom. Now retired, if you can call it that, he spends most of his time out here in the wild. On this trip to the Audubon Corkscrew Sanctuary in southwest Florida, Hampton is anxious to see what images his remote cameras have picked up.
Some deer.
There's also a bird and, well, an SUV, too, coming down the narrow dirt path.
That's such a
But
good
something
feeling.
More jumps out of the viewfinder, a rare
kind
shot
of
Florida panther, a young mom. Hampton's seen her before.
I recognize her. She's got three kittens.
Hampton took up photography half a dozen years ago. His award-winning African lion image hung in the Smithsonian.
And all of a sudden, the lion just exploded coming across that water.
Here's the kicker. Like Hampton never had a class or formal training. As a kid, he won a camera in a contest, but never used it.
Because we didn't have any money to buy film or get it developed anyway.
He's got the money now. He was CEO of five different companies over 40 years. But this is about more than a guy who just runs around taking pictures.
I've been lucky that things turned out well for me. I afford to do this kind of thing. And it's time for me to give back in life.
Giving back by donating to charity 40% of the money from the sale of limited edition coffee table picture books. Even at $2,000 a book, Hampton doesn't make a dime.
I don't want to make any money. And
you lose money.
I do.
Break even?
No, I don't. But that's not important to me as long as my wife and I can still afford to do it.
For each book, Hampton starts with 10,000 images, weeding out those with the subtlest of imperfections until he's down to 50. The books, one on the Everglades, the other Africa, are then hand-assembled at a local photo studio.
Oh, I told him anytime he wants to take me, he can. I'm ready to go.
In a few short years, the sale of individual images and books has raised more than $100,000 for a charity in Illinois called Carpenter's Place and for the Corkscrew Sanctuary. The Salvation Army and Ronald McDonald House are next up. Hampton certainly has an eye for photography, capturing the eyes of a gator and the eye of an elephant.
I don't think there are too many duds in there.
Oh, I hide those fast.
His next book, Alaska. John Zarella, CNN, in the Corkscrew Sanctuary.